back out to the Discovery Museum. I'm sure that's something that the scientists are driving home to the kids and the families out there, Tamara.
They are. You know, really, Chris, it's all about education here. And I know that Dirk was just talking about Venus in transit, which happens in early June. And what they're actually doing here at the museum right now, a lot of the families kind of packing up from their picnic as they did witness the peak of the solar eclipse. And now they're actually heading back into the planetarium for another little lecture all about what the kids can see as the moon starts to rise now, the constellations, and also talking about the Venus in transit as well. I wanted to bring back in, though, this is Dr. Bekah Shepard, and she is a geobiologist. And I want to talk a little bit about, you know, what everyone just kind of witnessed right now. Kind of recap it for us.
Sure. So remember that we were looking at an annular eclipse. So that means that we were real close to seeing the center of the moon over the center of the sun. Now here we were just south of where it'll be fully annular. So we saw more than 90% of that sun covered. And I'll tell you what, you know how good it was when you see the kids walk out of their first planetarium show. And they hold up their solar viewers and their faces just light up.
Just lit up, that's right. Now tell us what's happening right now as we speak. We've seen the peak of it already. So what's happening in the orbit?
Right, so of course the moon will continue to track right across the sun. So we'll get more and more partial, right? We'll start seeing more and more of that sun come back out. And then in the planetarium tonight, we're actually gonna then talk about what else we can see in the sky tonight as that sun goes down, right? This is actually a good night to look at the sky because we won't have much moon, new moon, once it gets out of the way of the sun. So good night to look at the stars. So yeah, there's always something going on in the sky, so we'll talk about.
Okay, real quickly, people have taken time to make those pinhole viewers. Tell me what they can use them for now that the eclipse is over.
Ah, great question. So pinhole viewers can be used to observe the sun at any time. The sun is not a boring place. You really can keep an eye on sunspots, so take it out, check it out. You can even try mapping sunspots. So if you see a little dark spot up here on the sun, track it right down when you see it. It may have been a huge solar flare.
Awesome. Thank you so much. That sounds like a project for Dirk Verdorn, because I think he's going to be doing that momentarily. I'll send it back to you.
Yeah, good news there, Tamara. Dirk's going to be able to keep his pinhole viewer for many years to come now.